In this video, we're going to look at the GP Snapshot feature that's part of the GP Cloud Migration tool. The GP Snapshot allows you to bring over transactional information from GP into Business Central in extension tables. The data can be viewed in list pages found in Business Central. Let's take a closer look at how you can configure the GP Snapshot. Once you walk through the Cloud Migration Wizard, you are presented with the GP Company Migration Configuration page. This page can also be navigated to from the Cloud Migration Management page. If we scroll to the bottom, we can see a section called Historical Snapshot. You can indicate what module transactions you would like migrated to Business Central. Once you select the module transactions, you can indicate how far back you want to bring over the transactional data. The system will default in the year that you indicated for your GL summary. However, you can certainly tweak that if you want that to be different. For example, you may want to bring over the last 3 years of GL summary information, but maybe you want to go back 7 years for the snapshot information. You simply need to select and enter in a different year to bring over the snapshot data. Once you complete the information in the GP Company Migration Configuration page, you can begin the migration. The GP Snapshot will run automatically once the migration is complete. You can monitor the progress of the snapshot by looking at the tiles in the Cloud Migration Management page. Once the snapshot process is finished, you can view the data in Business Central. Next, let's look at some of the snapshot data that was migrated. We'll first begin by viewing GL detail information. To navigate to that, we'll go to the chart of accounts. Under the chart of accounts, you can navigate under account and then see an option for GP detail snapshot. There are two options to select in here. They both show the same data. The second one just organizes the data by the account number. If I go into the All Detail Transactions, you can see a lot of the information that was migrated over from GP to Business Central. In here, you can see this information comes from the GP 20,000 and 30,000 tables. So that is the detail tables in GP for both your open and history. You can see the account numbers or the account string that users are familiar with in GP, as well as the debit and credit amounts. Like any list page in Business Central, you can export this information out to Excel. You can also filter on it and search for anything. So for example, if you were searching for a specific journal entry number, you could enter that into the search, and then the page will automatically filter. So you can see these are all the accounts that were posted to with the debit and credit amounts for this journal entry number. If the transaction came from a subledger, you can drill back on that journal entry number to see that subledger transactions. In this case, this was a sales order processing invoice. So at the top, you can see this is the header information for my sales transaction. And then down below, you can see all the transaction lines that were associated with the invoice. If any of these items were had serial or lot number tracking, you could drill back on the quantity and see their serial or lot information. Next, let's take a look at customer transactions. If I navigate to my customer list in Business Central, there will be a very similar option that I saw in the chart of accounts. If I navigate under customer, I'll see the same option, GP detail snapshot. This is where I can see my receivables and sales order processing transactions. If I navigate to the forms through this way, I will see transactions for all customers. If, however, you want to see transactions for a specific customer, select that customer for the list and then choose one of the tiles on the right side. I'll go ahead and select the receivables transactions. Now the list will filter to just the transactions for Aaron Fitz Electrical. Again, you can drill back to see more information about the individual transaction. So in this case, I can drill back and see that receivables transaction information. I can also see if any payments were applied to this invoice. So the snapshot will also include apply information for both receivables and payables documents. The very same information can be seen for vendors. So if I navigate under vendors, there's another option for the historical snapshot for your vendors. Here I can see my payables information, as well as any purchase receiving transactions, Again, if I navigate through the navigation here, I will see it for all vendors. There are also tiles on the right-hand side again, which will filter based on the vendor selected. Finally, we can see information about items. So if I navigate under items, snapshot information is also brought over for my inventory transactions. Since there isn't tiles for the item list, you can navigate to it only under items and then the GP detail snapshot. And that's a quick look at the GP snapshot feature that's available in the GP Cloud Migration tool. To learn more about Business Central, check out the training modules at aka.ms/bclearn. There are also additional resources available to partners.